Greetings everyone, you are welcome here. This video is part 3 of programming methodology using Java NetBeans, and in this video we will talk about simple Java programs, how to write simple programs in Java NetBeans. So this is example 1. The question is, write a program to input 2 numbers and display the result of adding these numbers. That is, you have to input 2 numbers and you have to add them and display the result. So the step 1 is, we have to create a project. Now, to create a project, choose file, new project. You can see here, file and then new project. And alternately, you can also click the new project icon in the toolbar. The second point is, from the categories pane, select Java, and in the projects pane, choose Java application. You can see here, from the categories, choose Java, and from projects, choose Java application, and then click next. Now the third part, enter a name. In this case, I have entered my programs as the name of the project in the project name field and specify the project location. See, this is the project location. You can specify the project location by clicking on the browse button, and by default, the project is saved in the NetBeans project folder in my documents. But you can change it if you wish to change. Ensure that set as main project checkbox is selected, and please clear the create main class field and then click on finish. Now the step 2, after creating a project, the next step is to add a JFrame form. So to add a JFrame form, first point is, in the projects window, right click the My Programs node. You can see here, this is the My Program. This is the name of the project which I gave in step number 1. Then right click here, and then from new option, choose JFrame form. Then you enter example 1. You can give the name of your choice. Here I am giving example 1 as the class name, and this will be the name of your form also. And then click finish. So NetBeans creates example 1 form within the application and opens the form in the builder, and we can now add the components to this form. The step 3 is designing the screen. Now the form has 2 parts, the source and the design. On the design part, we will design our screen. And in the source part, we will write down the coding. So in the design screen, as we have to input 2 numbers and add them, so we have dragged, this is a swing controls which are available. So we'll drag 3 labels, one for enter one number, first number, second for enter second number, and third for addition. So these are the 3 labels. Then we drag 3 text fields. These are the text fields we'll drag from here, and we will add 2 buttons, one for adding and second for exiting the application. So what you have to do after dragging them, just go to their properties and change the text property of first label as enter one first number, second label as enter second number, and third label as addition. Similarly, change the text property of text field also. Here JTextField1 is written, please remove it and empty the content of JTextField1. This is JTextField2, empty the content of this text field also. And then this is JTextField3, empty the content of this text field also. Then you change the text property of button also. You can see here, this is selected and I have changed it to exit. Similarly, change the text property of this button and make it add. In this way, the design of my screen is ready and the next part is coding. Now step 4 is writing the code. So for writing the code, we will go to the source code window and write the code on the click event of add button and also for exit button. Now the first one is the code for add button and the second one is for exit button. So let's see what we have to write for the code. Now the code is int a comma b comma c, a equal to integer dot parse it, j text field 1 dot get text, b equal to integer dot parse it, j text field 2 dot get text, c is equal to a plus b, then j text field 3 dot set text double quotes plus c. And for the exit button, the code is system dot exit and then within the parenthesis 0. Now the step 5 is running the application, and to run the application we use shift and F6 key. So when we will run the application, we will enter the first number, which is 10. Then we will enter the second number. Suppose I have entered 2. So if we click on the add button, 30 will be displayed. And if we will click on the exit button, the application will end. Now let us understand this code in depth. Now the first statement is int a comma b comma c. So this statement will create three variables of type integer for storing the values of first number, second number and the result of addition of these two numbers. Now the second statement is a is equal to integer dot parse int j text field 1 dot get text. Now here the get text method will get the text stored in j text field 1. So if we look at the example, so it will get the text that is 10, which is stored in j text field 1, and then the integer dot parse int method will convert this text to integer, and the integer obtained is assigned to variable a. So we will now the variable a, the value of variable a will become 10. Now the second third statement is b is equal to integer dot parse int j text field 2 dot get text. So again in this, the get text method will get the text stored in j text field 2. So you can see here in this example the text is 20. So 20 will be get text will get this text, and integer dot parse int method will convert it into integer, and the value 20 will then be assigned to variable b. So after this statement, variable b will have the value 20. So the next statement is c equal to a plus b. So in this, when we this statement is executed, a will be replaced by the value which is stored in it, that is 10, and b is also replaced by the value which is stored in this variable, that is 20. So 10 plus 20 is added and the result 30 will be stored in c. Now the next statement in this, j text field 3 dot set text double quotes plus c. So in this we concatenate variable c with the empty string. So this will convert this number into text, and then the set text method will set this text in j text field 3. You can see we will get the result 30 in j text field 3. So this is the explanation of the code, and let us go to example 2. Now in example 2, the question is write a program to input the sales of a salesman in north, south, east and west zones. Calculate and display the total sales. So again, the step number 1 is create a project. If the project is already created, do not create it again. You can directly go to step number 2. Step 2 is add a JFrame form. So you know, by right clicking on the project, we will select new and then JFrame form. So new form will be added. Now step 3 is design a screen. So we will go to the design area and add the desired components. And after adding all the components, according to the given question, my screen will look like this. So all these are labels and these are the text fields and this is a button. So we have label for north, south, east and west and one for total sales. Similarly, we have text fields for entering the sales of north zone. This is for south zone. This is for east zone and this is for west zone. And in this text field, the total sales will be displayed. And the coding will be done on the click event of the calculate button. Now step 4 is code writing. So we have to calculate the sum of the sales of all the 4 zones. So let us see what is the coding part on the click event of this button. The code is like this: int n comma s comma e comma w comma t, where n is for north, s is for south, e is for east and w is for west and t is for total sales. So the statements are: n is equal to integer dot percent j text field 1 dot get text, s equal to integer dot percent j text field 2 dot get text, e equal to integer dot percent j text field 3 dot get text, w is equal to integer dot percent j text field 4 dot get text, t is equal to n plus s plus e plus w, and then j text field 5 dot set text double quotes plus t. And after writing this code, we will run the application using shift and F6 key. So you can see here, after running, we are entering the sales of north, south, east and west zone. And when we click on the calculate button, the total sales, the total of all these sales will be displayed in this text field. So let us understand each statement of this code. Now the first one is int n comma s comma w comma e comma t. So this statement will create 5 variables, total 5 variables. 4 variables n, s, w and e, they are created for storing the sales of north, south, west and east zone. And the variable t is created or declared to store the value of total sales. Now the statement n equal to integer dot percent j text field 1 dot get text. In this statement, first the get text method will get the text stored in j text field 1. In this example, it will get the value 30, and integer dot percent will convert this text to integer. That is, 30 is converted to integer and then it will be stored in the variable n. So after this statement, the value of n is 30. Now the next statement, s equal to integer dot percent j text field 2 dot get text. Again, in this, the get text method will get the text stored in j text field 2, that is 50 in this case. And the integer dot percent method will convert this text to integer, and then the value 50 will be assigned to the variable s. And similarly, the sales of west and east zone will be stored in variable e and w respectively, 20 and 60 respectively. After that, the statement t is equal to n plus s plus e plus w will calculate the total sales. N will be replaced by the value 30, s will be replaced by value 50, e will be replaced by value 20 and w will be replaced by value 60. All of them will be added and the final value will be stored in variable t, which is 160. And then the statement j text field 3 dot set text double quotes plus t. In this statement, the integer t, the value integer value of t is converted to text by concatenating it with an empty string, and then this text is set into JText field 3 with the help of method setText. So at the end you can see the text 160 in JText field 5. Now the next example is write a program to input cost of one pencil and number of pencils. Calculate and display total cost of pencils. Now the step one is create a project. Again, if the project is already created, do not create it again. You can directly go to step two. Now in step two, add a JFrame form. And step three is designing of screen. So we'll design a screen like this. There are three text labels: cost of one pencil, number of pencils, and total cost. Again, three text fields. The first one for entering the cost of one pencil, second one for entering the number of pencils, and third one for displaying the total cost. And then there are two buttons. The first one for calculating the total cost and the second one for exiting the application. Now after designing, we will go to the coding part. Now on the click event of calculate cost button, the code is int a comma b comma c, a equal to integer dot %, JText field 1 dot getText, b equal to integer dot %, JText field 2 dot getText, c equal to a into b, and then JText field 3 dot setText double quotes plus c. For the exit button, the coding is system dot exit and 0. So after writing the code, the next step is to run the application, and to run the application we use shift and F6 key, and you can see we will input 10 as the, we are entering 10 as the cost of one pencil, and if 20 is the number of pencils we want to buy, then the total cost will be 10 into 20, which is 200. So let's understand the code. Now the first statement is int a comma b comma c. So this statement will create three variables, a, b, and c. A for inputting the cost of one pencil, B for storing the total number of pencils, and C for displaying the total cost of pencils. Now the statement A is equal to integer dot %, JText field 1 dot getText will get the text stored in JText field 1, that is 10 in this case. And then integer dot %, will convert 10 into integer and it will be assigned to variable a. So after this statement, the value of variable a is 10. Now the next statement, b is equal to integer dot %, JText field 2 dot getText will get the text stored in JText field 2, that is 20 in this case. And integer dot %, will convert this text into integer, and the integer 20 will then be assigned to variable b. So after this statement, the value of variable b is 20. Now the statement c is equal to a into b. In this case, the value of a is 10 and the value of b is 20. So 10 is multiplied by 20 and the result is 30, which is assigned to variable c. Now the next statement will set the value of c to text field 3. First, it is concatenated with an empty string to convert integer to string, and then the setText method which set the text in the JText field 3. You can see 200 is displayed here. So this is all for this video. If you like this video, kindly give thumbs up, and you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.